Built for the American military in the 60s in the Vietnam War. They cost the American military $1 million each, and I acquired this from the French military. The dealer bought 10 of them, gone from America to the French military, and I bought this one off the dealer in Belgium, and it's taken me 2 years to restore it. And as you can see, it's a fantastic machine. We've been in the water maybe about two trial runs of an hour each, and then when the three queens were down the river, we went down for 5 hours. So last week we decided to come over to the show at Woodvale. So as you can see, we're here now. We've been here for 2 days. Our original with 50 caliber machine guns, as you can see over there, which we used in the Vietnam War down the Mekong River, where the duck protected itself on both sides of the river with the 50 caliber. And you notice also that the bow is down, so when the troops went ashore, the two 50 caliber guns would in actual fact fire over their heads and protect them from the enemy.
Right, so can you tell me a few of the specifications about the vehicle, for instance, what it's made of?
It's actually made of salt resistant aluminium. From what I gather, it's about 8 mm thick. As you can see, there's a 3-foot propeller driving in the water. And it has two cooling systems, one for driving on the road. As you can see, it drives this way on the road. We've got the headlights, wing mirrors, and wipers up there. drives this way on the road and the other way at sea. There's two seats in it. Two seats and two steering wheels, so you can swap from one side to the other, whether you're at sea or on the road. It's got two Cummins V8 diesels in it. As you can see, the two coolers are on the road. But when you go in, they're fresh water in them, are the same fresh waters in the engine and also in these seat coolers. So when it's going in the opposite direction, these heat exchangers, in effect, steal the heat from the engine and cool it.
So effectively, this propeller acts like an impeller, like a jet type system.
Actually, I suppose you could describe it as a early jet drive. If you notice, the hull is a catamaran for about half its length, and it gathers the water at the far end, which is 10 foot wide, and pressurizes the water into the prop, which is only 3 feet wide. And you notice the quartz nozzle on the bottom also scoops down into the water and pressurizes it. And it's supposed to be 10% more effective with that quartz nozzle, and obviously it protects the prop as well. And then, as you can see, the rudder has got a three-bladed rudder. And the idea of the jet drive on the rudder, of course, because it'll operate in, it says in the book that it'll operate in the highly demanding surf zone. So when you come ashore, to stop it surfing and the waves, that's why this rudder is built with the three blades in it. And also, it's, like I said before, it's an early jet drive, which will keep it steady going ashore in the surf. And they were built in California, so obviously, knowing the Americans, they would have tested in the sea in California. So if it was handled it there, it'll handle the water here without any problem. And we crossed the river Mersey the other day, and I would consider maybe a force 5, which was no trouble at all. And I did have an earlier model of this in the 80s, and I've actually been out in a force 9 in it without any problem. So I have plenty of confidence crossing the river.
Just to recap, do you know the engine size?
Yes, it's got two Cummins V8 diesels, 15 litres each.
15 litres?
Yeah, as I said before, they're cooled by the exchanger in the water and the radiators on the beach. If you care to come round to the tyres. The reduction in these is something in the region of 25 to 1. There's a drive shaft for each wheel, and there are disc brakes on each of those inboard shafts, so in actual fact there's no brakes out in the weather. It's just a direct drive.
A very sensible system.
Yes.
So it doesn't have any suspension as such.
No.
Conventional wise,
it relies solely on the tyres, the flotation tyres that are actually off earth movers. But obviously they won't suffer on the beach at all, because they're quite used to working on building sites.
I see. You know. So they're still easily obtainable?
Yes.
Yes. £5,000 each.
You can actually buy Chinese ones, which are £3,000. And obviously you'll notice that it's four-wheel drive configuration and four-wheel steer. Drive on the road, because there's no direct drive to the axles, they're all hydraulics, so I have to drive it with the rear wheels fixed until I come to a roundabout or bend, or I cut the corner off on the roundabout.
So you've done much of the restoration?
Yes.
Personally, or
personally I've done all the restoration, all the wheels, all the drives. When I bought it, all the seals, I'd let it down. Obviously it's 40 odd years of age. And mainly the seals have let it down, the water had got into the axles. And I've renewed all the bearings in both all four wheels, all the drive shafts and the propeller shaft as well. All new hardy spices and bearings and the whole thing.
It certainly does you credit. You've done an excellent job on the whole machine.
Yeah, thanks very much.
It almost looks like brand new.
Yeah. Most people are pointing that out to me. I did polish, as you can see, the sort of pattern into it.
I see.
And it was originally, it wasn't painted, so I just kept it the same. It's obviously a salt-resisting aluminium.
Yes.
I would have sooner showed it to you just as it came out of the water, because it's all nice and clean, but unfortunately we've been riding down the beach. As you can see, the bow falls down to allow you to drive a 15-ton truck on it, or troops, whatever. You can see the technology in it in the 60s. It's fantastic, and I've been fascinated by the machine. And it's also the heaviest vehicle of festivals in the world since I was a child, really, you know. This is the ultimate toy. As never Archie said,
Very true. Basically, what I need to do is I need to put my four-wheel drive on. There's me three-wheeling hubs, because I'm about to drive it onto the back of that amphibious duck there. That's that. They're on. About 40 years old, I believe, this amphibious duck. Now, levers. I want it in low ratio. Dip the clutch on, I think. I was nervous about hitting them. Yeah, I was saying to him yesterday, I was nervous about making it like the Italian job where I've got to apply the brakes as soon as I get to the top. I don't want to bump anyone. So I don't want to go moving this. I'm going to leave the brakes on. I don't want to harm anyone.
A bit more.
Okay, right, if you're sure.
Just watch yourself over there. Go. Aren't we, Harry? Now, officially aboard.
Right, I was nervous about that.
Your old
stopping the bugger.
Do you want to say if it's that road?
Well, I'm on. I think we should get out, maybe go and video it from a few points.
Yeah.
You want to give us the camera, Matt?
Yep, I agree.
So.
Try and close the ramp.
Right. We sure we're okay? We will. They're only jeeps, we'll squash them in, yeah.
See, the problem he's got is it's this frame. If it wasn't for the frame, it would have got
more of them in here. So I wouldn't have liked to see four trying to get in here.
Don't forget, you come right over here once you get in. Come right to the edge.
Right. I hope you've got a hand signal to tell him to stop.
Yeah. Just scream.
What angle does it... Does it you know.
Oh, the grounds, mate. Yeah.
Where are you going?
What do you think on... I was a bit nervous. Couldn't get it into low ratio until I was just coming up to the path.
In low ratio.
Well, I didn't want to accelerate into the back. This is how you crush three Willys Jeeps. That's good news. Oh. Now I'm worried. Yeah, now I'm worried.
You're covered with that,
yeah? Yeah. Okay. I did think there might be a problem. Ooh, bang me head. I wanted to go round up there and video it, you know. But I can't get round unless I climb through the Jeep. I'd like to just nip round and maybe video from below before we come out, if that's okay. Give us a couple of minutes.
All right.
Matt, this way.
Yeah.
don't know what, if I can get around there now. Take my hat off.
Drop it over.
Yeah.
They won't be on next year.
Okay. I just thought yesterday when you said four, I thought that sounds like a tough job.
like you said, if they're framed right there.
Yeah. Yeah. I have a feeling I might have done, but anyway, I always take it twice. John, is this one of yours for your 50 cals? Anyway.
Do you edit it when you go back?
Yeah, I do. Put it, edit everything if I can before I put it on YouTube. Yeah, but brilliant. Oh, well, was it worth coming today then, just for this?
Oh, definitely.
Good. You're not a scaffolder, are you?
Bricklayer by trade.
Oh, of course, yeah, you told me, that's it, yeah, you told me yesterday. Bricklayer by trade, no wonder you don't mind climbing up things like this.
I wouldn't be interested in the mechanics on this trade.
I understand that, yes. Very good. And you live on the Wirral, yes? Bidston Way.